answer that question tonight. So, I don't know why it's prompting me to talk to him again.
Good day, Desade. How can I help you?
Does he have more to tell us? Not secrecy?
I met the representative of the Ordo Luminis, and he spoke of his fears concerning the Nauts.
That hardly surprises me. That man is full of pride and arrogance, and sees evil wherever he gazes.
And that bishop is not made of milk and kindness, but his questions are intriguing. He suspects you to be somehow responsible for the Malachor because you never fall prey to it.
Responsible for the Malachor? And how?
Through your magic. Some sort of ritual. Do you use a magic very similar to that of the natives?
I have nothing more to say about it. Those are merely the fantasies of a lunatic. More questions?
Fine then, keep your secrets.
Thanks. I've got everything I need. The commander will probably not tell us anything more about the Nort's secrets, but the documents at the Harbor Master's office may teach us something new, if we can stay discreet.
Good thing I didn't sell my sailor gear.
Good day.
Hey, sailor.
I'm looking for several sailors. Some Nort have disappeared a few days ago.
Sorry, that doesn't ring any bells. But I did hear talk like everyone else on the port, but that's all. You should ask the Mage Inquisitors who have taken up lodgings here of late. They must have certainly seen something. We see them everywhere, and they spend their time spying on all that moves, especially eyeing all that the Nauts are up to.
And what do these Mage Inquisitors look like?
They wear a very peculiar symbol.
We cannot question all the Inquisitors roaming around the island, especially considering what we've learned from Demetius. They must be doing everything in their power to discover the Nort's secrets.
You'll never get me Lucky Charms. My throat has been like scratchy the last couple of days, I don't know why. Alright, so here we are, it's nighttime now, and we're going to see if we can meet Candy Cane. There he is!
Good evening. Are you the one they call Candy Cane?
Who are you?
Desade, legate of the merchant congregation.
A legate, no less. I imagine in these cases, the one accompanying you is the famous Petrus.
You seem to be very well informed. Therefore, you might be able to answer my question. What do you know about a woman in a green coat?
Why would I tell you?
We know that you have business with this woman, and that she is actually the Mother Cardinal.
How did you... You would be better off forgetting that.
That's not exactly the response I'd imagined. But nevertheless, seems rather eloquent.
I told you to forget about it, or you'll soon run into trouble. Legate or no legate.
Come on, it was just an innocent little conversation. Goodbye, Mr. Kane.
Bye, and Godspeed.
That was fruitful information.
Really? Is the fact that she bets on fights that are potentially fixed enough for you?
It's already a huge scandal. Let me just think about it for a little while. I will find a way of putting this information to good use.
I have faith in you, Father.
So we're going to be receiving a cut of her winnings. In return, we won't squeal on her. Is that it? Admiral's notes. Please have the dolphin cry of Trident repair as quickly as possible. Also make sure to replace the barometer. One on the board is not as precise as it should be. The crew wasn't able to steer clear of the storm in time, which caused us to sail. Be discreet. Inquisitors are watching us. Admiral Cabral.
already seen this type of engine in my uncle's court. It's used to spy upon the stars. Nothing magic nor impure therein. They're nothing but measuring instruments.
It's a sextant. A telescope. Do I look like a sailor to you?
These machines are extremely complex. I've never seen anything like this. Oh. This one looks like it has a shouting dolphin etched into its side.
What a coincidence.
And that, it looks like a thermometer. And this other machine, does it really predict the weather? These instruments are incredible and I would be hard-pressed to use them. But I certainly see nothing magic in here, nor anything diabolical. For as long as they work and are really used, these instruments seem to be the product of science. And I've definitely found
science.
Nothing related to the Malachor, nor a secret sect or cult. This Domitius has let his imagination and the taste of Nort's secrets get the best of him.
So it's nothing, Burger. Came here for nothing.
The Ordo Luminis was completely wrong. We must find these missing Nauts.
We must see the Nauts. We must be not seas. Can a boy wear that? Longshoreman.
Good day. I'm looking for two men, Nauts, that went missing a few days ago. Do you know anything about them?
Why? As a matter of fact, I do. 3 or 4 days ago, I was at the tavern having a conversation with a sailor, a nice fellow. He was telling these stories. He was drinking hard. He went outside for a moment to, you can imagine, and well, he never came back. He wasn't that drunk to have passed out. If it were that, we would have found him. No, something happened to him. That's a fact. But I would be at a loss to tell you what.
If one of the sailors disappeared as he came out of the tavern, that is where we should go. If we find Inquisitors there, they'll certainly know more than the ones we see here.
We already did this storyline, remember? It turns out his family took him back. He was the cabin boy.
Approaching the tavern.
If we're discreet, we should be able to eavesdrop on a conversation.
But which conversation? That one?
When are we going to act? Our men are twiddling their thumbs, and that's bad for their morale. Let's not even speak about the guards at the prison. Who likes having clandestine prisoners in their jails?
You are impatient. We haven't been able to get out of them what we need to hear, but it won't be long. Then we can act and launch the grand purification of the Nauts. While waiting, keep your men on a leash, especially those in the jails. If the Mother Cardinal learns that you are detaining Nauts in a cell in your barracks,
we'll be in muddy waters. But then you will too. No need to remind me.
They're gone.
May the Enlightened forgive them for their foolishness. We must set these Nauts free from the Coin's jails as soon as possible. This could cause a major diplomatic incident if it came to light. As for this purification, I'm afraid we'll have to act fast, my child.
I'm gonna give them a bath, are they?
Feast for the eyes, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. I'm right, the steward designed this brothel. Look at all the throw pillows. Hi, can you release these prisoners?
Halt! You have no authority to go any further.
Do not forget that there is only one song that can make us change our minds, Greenblood.
Played with golden notes.
You said it. Or songs of steel. They also open doors.
I don't want to cause a scene, do I?
And if I gave you this, so that you might go and have a little fun?
In that case, I could certainly look the other way for a while, but be discreet.
Just doing his job.
Thank you. Thank you for getting us out of there.
Those Inquisitors are completely mad. They tortured us. They wanted us to admit to all manner of horrors. Stories of some demonic cult and curses of Malachor. I was of the firm belief that they were going to kill us. But you must make haste. They are planning some sort of wickedness.
They spoke of a great purification. And after that, they did this to us. It doesn't bode well. Not at all. I heard them talking about their headquarters near the palace. Maybe you'll learn something there of interest. Thank you again for freeing us. We'll be able to make it back to port on our own.
We need to discover what is behind this talk of purification before they can execute their plan. Taking into consideration what we learned in the warehouse, it will not be difficult to convince the Mother Cardinal to intervene.
Mother Cardinal, she's a gambling. Torture chamber, is that proof? Old antique helmet. Rusty hunting dagger is worth 30 gold. Well, say so. What were they hiding up here, I wonder? Ah, a candlestick. Bastards. Message from the Inquisitor to Bishop Domitius. Purification of knots will begin as soon as we have in our jails have confessed. We will have enough proof then to convince the Mother Cardinal to let us act. It is high time we eliminated these heretics who have been allowed to circulate our cities freely. Until then, stay discreet. We would be in a delicate situation if our plan were to be revealed too early.
We must meet with the Mother Cardinal urgently. Only she can put an end to this madness. Your Eminence, I salute you.
Sir de Sade, what can I do for you?
Who are the missionaries?
It is an order that aims to convert people. You must have met some of its followers in Serene. Most of them leave the comfort of Teleme to visit other countries, to spread the good word. This once relatively minor order has become quite significant in recent years. And has established itself in politics in the highest positions of our nation.
Now, by the way, there's a plot to ethnically cleanse the city.
I must leave you.
Naturally, Your Excellency.
Yes? I would like to have an audience with the Mother Cardinal to discuss the discoveries made during our investigation.
What is this about, Domitius?
Well, I don't rightly know.
Plausible deniability, eh?
You see, Eminence, Bishop Domitius has brought to my ears his order's accusations concerning the Nauts. According to him, they practice a religion close to those of the natives and use a nature-drawn magic. They would also be implicated, therefore, in the appearance of the Malachor.
That is an extremely serious accusation.
Effectively, considering the accusation is founded on no proof other than the Nauts' tradition of secrecy. But these suspicions have pushed the Order to extreme actions, risking the fragile peace of the island.
The events. Tell us about the events.
The Ordo Luminis captured several Nauts, locked them in jails rented to them by the Coin Guard. They were tortured with the singular goal of forcing them to admit heresy. They obtained nothing. If I had not intervened, these men would be dead.
Is this true, Domitius?
Some of our brothers undoubtedly misinterpreted the evil. I would have never allowed such a plan.
These Nauts are now united with their captain, and I am certain they would be most eager to bear testimony. Following up on the accusations of Bishop Domitius, I wanted to verify for myself what this was all about. I went to take a look at their storerooms and saw what they contained. There were neither idols nor objects of any ritual, nor even anything magical, and absolutely nothing that could be attributed to the origin of the Malachor. I found nothing but measuring instruments and diverse navigational machines. I caught wind of a ridiculous scheme planned for the port by the Ordo Luminis, and I wanted to clear it up. I was able to get my hand on documents that effectively detailed an attack, a great purification. They were signed by you, Father, and included a contract where you enlisted the assistance of the Coin Guard to attack every Nought building and make prisoner of every one of their men that could be taken alive.
Domitius, how could you? Whatever did you want to accomplish?
The Noughts are not believers. We should not be dependent on heretics.
Have you gone completely mad, Domitius? We are on an island. How could we not be dependent on the Noughts? I want them arrested. Him and every member of his order. I will decide at a later time their fate. I thank you for bringing this business to my attention. Going after the Noughts? What madness. Without you, this city would now be drowning in chaos. Carry my best wishes to your cousin. His desire to maintain the peace on the island honors his house's reputation.
I will tell him, Your Eminence, until we meet again.
Plus one reputation after all that. Uh-oh. Letter from the secretary of the embassy. A group of natives came to this embassy and asked to see you. As they could not find you, they asked me to give you the location of the forest where they hoped you will meet them. If I may, they seemed relatively agitated and aggressive. So be careful. Yours respectfully. Good to know. I'll add it to the agenda. Meeting with natives. You know what that means. I think this is the DLC content. Oh, is this on the same map? It is, neat.
Please, I come because of a message that was sent to me.
Wait. This is the Onol Menawi of the Lugay the Blanc, the one we wanted to talk to.
Yeah.
I came following the instructions you had left the secretary of our embassy.
Why is there a dead body here?
But I wasn't expecting to find you near the corpse of a member of the Ordo Luminis.
We were told that there was a man different from the other in Nyxair amongst the Lugayan Blanc. Someone who sometimes helped our people. This is why we talked to the man in the large house. But we don't really know who you are.
My name is Desarde. I'm the legate of the congregation. It means that I'm in charge of the diplomacy with the other nations. And yes, I have helped your people a few times.
A diplomat is someone who talks, right? Not someone who fights.
Can you do both?
I know how to fend for myself, if that's your question. But will you tell me why you made me come here?
2 nights ago, we attacked a group of Red Sons who were taking away some of our people. Many of them fled. But we captured this man, and we made him talk. We wanted to know where they took our brothers. And he talked about a secret camp.
Why would the Inquisition take natives to
another
a secret camp?
Secret camp?
To confuse their minds. They torture them until they renounce the truth and praise the sun. This Red Sun was mocking us. He said they would burn us, like the others. He had killed some of my brothers, so I killed him.
If what you say is true, then indeed, we cannot let the Inquisitors continue. But because you killed him, we can only take your word for it.
Maybe not. The Red Sun had a key on him, and also some words sealed in bark. We do not know how to set them free, but the Renaigse do, don't they?
The letter ordered this man to join the escort party of a group of natives. This partly confirms what you told me.
Do the words say where the camp is located?
No, but the address of the Inquisitor is written.
What is an address?
This is how we refer to the place we live in. I suppose the key you found is the key to his door.
So you can go to his house and look for more words?
I suppose so.
You must do it, or the Suns will keep burning our people.
It is unbelievable to me that despite the arrest of Domitius, the Ordo Luminis is still acting in such a way. Very well. I will go visit this man's home. I will come back to you if I learn anything more.
Hurry. Our brothers may be dying in the meantime.
In all fairness, probably started before we did that.
Go back to town. We'll wait for you here. We need to know where it
is. Locked.
You don't say. I wish we had a key.
If other sons come here, they'll burn me.
Letter found at the home of Father Claudius. I wanted to congratulate you for your work and your unwavering commitment to our conversion camp project. Thank you to your devotion, we were able to bring many savages towards the light. You will find some new elements and orders regarding continuation of our operations in your chest at our headquarters. May the Enlightened protect you. Inquisitor Honoris.
This letter mentions a secret camp. Apparently our man was involved in its creation. It also talks about a chest he would have had in the quarters of the Order, here in San Mateus. We may find clues there that will allow us to discover the location of the camp. If this chest exists, there must be a key. It has to be here. Let's continue searching.
Up.
It's a key. Most likely the key to a chest, with the emblem of the Ordo Luminis. I don't think we'll find anything else here. Let's leave and see what this chest contains.
Oh. Busted.
Hey, you. Who are you? And what are you doing in Father Claudius's home?
Cleaning.
Sade, I'm the legate of the congregation.
My colleague has been away for the last few days. May I know exactly what it is about your status as a diplomat that gives you the right to enter his home in his absence?
My status is the reason why the Mother Cardinal asked me to investigate. She wants to know where Father Claudius might have disappeared to. I offered to go to his home to see if I could find some information. Hence why I'm here.
Really? Well, I find that very strange. Why would the Mother Cardinal ask that some strangers who do not belong to our order try to find him?
How would we know? Perhaps you want us to go find her together. I'm sure she'll be delighted to see how you've been treating the representative of one of her allies.
That won't be necessary, but know that I am keeping an eye on you.
As you wish. I hope I don't see you again, Father.
I doubt this sly, bitter man believed your lies. Probably see him again.
We should make use of this moment of respite to go visit the quarters of the Order and find the chest there. There shouldn't be too many people left anyway, after what happened.
We were going there anyway, so yeah, I'd say that's a good call. Just killed guys here like a few minutes ago. They're still here. The bodies aren't even cold yet. We're back investigating a whole new plot. floor. Letter in Claudius' chest says, Claudius, we hope that you can count on you to accept a new delivery of native heretics in our camp. We would also like you to be in charge of conversions of the most refractory native subjects. I recommend you to follow the most discreet path possible in order to meet us. The path that goes between the rocks to the east of the city and leads to the secluded glade where we built the camp. As it is imperative that our operations remain secret for now. May the Enlightened protect you, the Ordo Luminis.
Thanks to these documents, we'll be able to show the natives where the conversion camp is, and the times when new prisoner convoys will get there too.
The Ordo Luminis is fearsome in a fight. If the natives attack the camp, they risk being slaughtered. But given the methods of the Inquisitors, I almost want to give them a hand.
They fight with zeal. Sisters in battle. The Inquisition.
So, did you discover anything?
I did. I found some information that should allow you to locate the conversion camp. And I also found a note about a prisoner convoy coming soon.
Why come and tell us all of this if your intention is just to betray us?
Betray you? How so?
You're not the ones this so-called legate betrayed. We are.
You? I have no commitment to your order. It is with Teleme that we are allied. Your nation. That you are prepared to drag into a war against the natives. With the sole purpose of converting a few of them in your torture camp, even if you have to kill all the others.
This camp is our only chance to ensure that the word of Saint Matthias is respected on this pagan island. You threw my brothers in jail cells, and now you would like to put an end to our work? You are nothing but servants of the insular demons, and you will pay for your blasphemies.
We will fight these monsters by your side, Ordo Luminis.
Children, no! I can't tell what's going on, man. I have too much shit on screen.
Thank you.
You don't have to thank me. These men were our enemy. The monsters torturing my people.
Even though the Ordo Luminis' actions are atrocious, Teleme must not learn of our involvement in this matter. Our alliance could suffer.
Do not worry about it. We won't tell them.
And we will make these bodies disappear. Nobody will ever know what happened to them.
Except for our Mal, of course. Queen Derdra will be grateful to you for helping us.
I hope this will help our relations in the future.
In any case, do not worry about this camp. She will not let our people be imprisoned. She may even ask for your help in destroying it.
Perhaps. In the meantime, please give her my regards.
Bertir Tumad on all Menawi. And thanks again.
I don't get to loot the bodies? Oh. That's like half the fun. Night Wolfran, I just started. Like, what class you pick and choice you make, does it affect the story? This is my first playthrough as well. So I'm not 100% sure. But usually different classes you're encouraged to spec into different things. So it might make some minor things, but I don't think it drastically affects the story.
Tirtumad on all Menawi. I am Derdra, daughter of Enora, daughter of Rowena, Mal of this clan. Is it you who helped my warriors discover what the men of the Red Sun were doing?
Indeed.
It was me.
Then I thank you. It's probably because you are an Onol Menawi that you are different from the other Renaixe. What do you seek?
Can you tell me something about your beliefs?
We believe that we are part of an everything, and that life depends on a balance that comes from this everything. Our strength is drawn from that which we protect, all that surrounds us, and that which surrounds us feeds and protects us in return.
All right. Well, I hope you have fun playing it, Night Wolf Run. If you like Fable, you should like this game. It's very similar.
What can you tell me about your rituals?
Ah, I have heard this question before. You sound like the Mind Shaker woman. The rituals are the business of the Donegada, not of the Renoixe. Anything more?
I don't think so.
I need to be going.
Well, I'm sick.
I have to be going. You're making me uncomfortable. What do you know? What are you guys doing?
Can't you leave us alone, Monisanaik?
No, I want in. I demand to know what you're doing.
Leave me be. Even your thoughts are loud and break my peace.
You schizo.
Traitor. An Anol Menawi does not wear the dress of the strangers.
Renaixeya Toigan Quahesa de Elodeis Summer Mila Machde Wegander.
Well, he's drunk. Let's not talk to him.
Birtir to Madre Renaixe.
Good day.
Do you want something?
Could you answer a few questions?
Questions, questions. It is a word that you adore. Let us play a game. If you answer my questions, I will answer yours.
Truth or dare?
It's the only way to get answers, then let's play.
I am pleased. We will have fun. But beware, no lies. What name is given the place from where you come?
I come from Serene, a grand city on the continent of Gekane.
Really? It is possible that you come from there. But I believe that this is not your land. Your turn.
The rituals.
What can you tell me about the rituals?
Oh, I see what interests you. You want to know how our warriors are so strong, but I don't have an answer. It is a secret of the Donega. The rituals I know are made to celebrate nature. To honor and bring her blessings upon us. Let's try something else. Are you on all Menawi with your land? Or did you inherit your link from your parents?
I'm not bound. Or at least I haven't done anything in particular to bind myself.
Then it was your parents. One of them at least must have been Donegal. Your turn.
Tell me about the missionaries that came
The Moines Shakers came here to our home and tried to convince us to abandon our ways. No one wanted to listen to them, so they finally decided to leave. I suppose that they were full of disappointment, or angry, or simply tired. And then the others arrived. The woman is truly strange. She is aggressive and spies on us at every turn. I would prefer that she leaves as well. It was fun. More than with a woman who makes light. She did not want to play.
She doesn't want to play.
Birtir Dumad, Anal Manawi. What do you want?
This question will seem strange to you, but do you know anything about a demon?
A demon?
A dark spirit, if you prefer.
No. There is no such thing as dark spirits. Your question is not strange. Foolish, perhaps.
What can you tell me about the beliefs of your village?
The beliefs of the village? That is a strange question for an Onol Manawi. Our beliefs are the same as those of the other clans. We believe in the earth that carries us and feeds on our dead, in the rain that quenches us and drowns us, in the beasts that feed us and in those that eat us. I do not know what more I can say to you. Everyone shares these beliefs.
Couldn't I just ask Soraya about this?
You're different from the others. What is your role in the village?
Different? Why?
Well, for one, you answer me when I speak.
You others, when we don't answer you, you start digging for answers everywhere else. I am a gatherer. I hunt a little. I do my part for the life of the village.
Tell me about the missionaries that came here. Those who wear the symbol of the sun on their clothing.
When they came, they spoke about their bright and shiny god. They told us we were wrong. Said that nature was just nature, and not to be worshipped. These men know nothing. We ignored them. They finally left, and then the woman came to us. She sniffed around everywhere, asking many questions. Just like you. I was told that she tried to enter my own home. I even saw her trying to follow me in the woods. She must be careful. It is easy to get lost in the woods or cross paths with wild beasts.
I must leave now. Thank you for your help. Anything new?
No. The investigation has gone stale. The villagers won't even engage in conversation with me now. Perhaps you should talk to them. They may speak to you.
I managed to exchange a few words with some villagers, but I admit they don't seem keen to talk.
And did they tell you anything worth sharing?
I know little more about their beliefs. They worship nature and do not intend to change. It is certainly different from the Luminis faith, but it's hardly demonic worship. Yet, there's something strange about this village. One of the villagers that spoke with me seemed truly worried. On edge, even.
I think I know of whom you speak. A man always looking over his shoulder. He often sneaks out of the village like a thief. I attempted to follow him, but he always eludes me.
Don't do
I
that.
I tried to get into his hut to see if he was hiding anything, but someone was always there.
Then we should give it a try. Perhaps we'll fare better.
This fellow did not seem very honest to me. If he's hiding something from us, perhaps we can find out what it is by searching his house.
He doesn't look inclined to let us in. We'll have to distract him.
You could break one of his pots. That would keep him busy. Or we could ask for help.
I can pretend to be clumsy, but we'll have to work fast, and it will only work once.
What are we trying to find out here again? We know they worship nature. I don't see why we're breaking in here.
Do you want something?
Might I ask you a few questions about the villagers?
More questions? You really like this game. You really do.
I do.
If we could avoid the...
Very well. But be brief then, because it is not good fun.
What can you tell me about that man down there? I spoke to him, and he seemed nervous.
Don't hold it against him. The people of the Light have already questioned us. That makes him distrustful. He is a man of few words. But he is devoted to the village and listens to the Danae God with great attention. He is a gatherer, but everyone knows he wants to become the next Voglendijk, the next servant of Danae God.
Where does this man live?
Down there. His dwelling is right in front of my own.
I would like to take a look inside.
What? Why would you want to do that? It is his home. You have nothing to do there if you are not invited.
I really must go inside. I need to clarify something. If you can help us.
This request is strange. I know it is for you as well. But we must prove that the suspicions cast upon our village are not true. These people of Teleme will not give up their search without this. Very well. I shall distract him. But be discreet and very quick. And be respectful of what you find there. Be good.
I won't squeal on his porn stash, I promise.
Oi! Toiges! Ready, I'm ready, Quan!
Sneak mode engaged.
What a horrible mask. How can someone wear such a thing unless they're worshipping some dark creature?
This is just a mask they wear in battle to intimidate their enemies, nothing more.
This altar is incredibly morbid. I wonder what sort of spirit could be venerated in this way.
This is exactly the kind of proof we've been looking for. An evil cult, far from some naive veneration of nature and other island spirits.
The man that worships a magic lamp speaks of being naive. Oh, how it is charming.
Siora, I am sorry. What I really wanted to say was that...
Leave it, old man. I know exactly what it is you wanted to say.
Stop the bigotry.
This painting is frightening. Evoking war. A massacre. A bloodbath under the likeness of a grimacing face.
All these gruesome and bloody horrors leave no room for doubt. There is a demonic cult here. We should go tell Sister Ephesia.
Kill them all. Okay, just take your ship over here too, why not?
you learn anything?
No. Nothing more. Were you able to get inside the nervous man's hut?
I was able to sneak into the hut of our mystery man.
And what did you discover?
Some troubling things. A ritual mask, a rather morbid altar, and a fresco depicting a massacre.
By the Enlightened! To think these unholy things were so near. Finally, the proof we need that there's a blood-worshipping cult here. They cannot perform their heinous pagan rituals in the village. And I'm certain that it's where our nervous friend sneaks off to. I fail to find where he goes. But you have already proven more competent than I.
I shall try. Hopefully he won't lead us into a trap.
Thank you for your help. And good luck.
We should wait until nightfall and follow him.
I don't know why Soraya doesn't speak out against this.
Here we could hide and wait. We would be able to see where this sleepless boy goes during nightfall.
My child, it's time to wake up. Our nervous friend is here.
Strange.
Where could our man have gone?
He must have gone through this door made out of roots.
Finally, some decent thumbnail material.
What's happening? You are so pale. Did the lightning-struck tree speak to you?
In a way. I saw many images. They were so real, as if I was the tree itself.
Do tell. This vision is surely the key to the portal.
I was this tree, and my branches were shaken by a storm so strongly that they hurt terribly. The heavens caught fire several times, and I felt the lightning strike and pierce me through and through. A sinister warmth took hold of my entire body in an instant, and flames began to devour me. Life left me. All was calm, and I had a taste of cinder in my mouth. In spite of this, I continued to feel, and the rain began to fall on my roots, and at the very heart of my being, I felt the sap begin to flow again. A shoot appeared on my darkened roots.
You chiseled your pants.
I have never experienced anything like it before.
To be the tree, you have to think like the tree. What is our stream time? Just under an hour and a half? Can we get in here? Find a way down to the passage.
This stone has an image of the moon.
Oh, it's one of these puzzles.
On this stone, the sun is visible. This drawing looks like an infant. Could it represent life? The drawing on this stone makes me think of fire. I'm certain. drawing on this stone resembles a symbol that must represent the Earth. This stone is adorned with the etching of a drop of water. This stone bears the image of a storm, or perhaps the wind. The drawing on this stone represents lightning. Here this looks like a snowflake. The snow, or maybe ice. This stone is blackened, eaten away. I think it's supposed to evoke death.
Wow. We have to activate these in the proper order, don't we? We did it! It took forever, but we did it! I'll never speak of this again.
What a strange ritual. I have never seen anything like it. The rituals of my village are not quite as scary.
In any case, the Leme's story suddenly sounds way more plausible. The Denegad who performed the ritual was the village's. We should go talk to Deirdre.
What do you seek?
We found your sanctuary and assisted in one of your blood rituals. What's the apparition we witnessed, the demon the priests were talking about?
What is clear is these priests know nothing and you know nothing.
The ritual. I've never seen anything like it. I hoped you'd be able to explain what they were trying to achieve. As you can see, my companion is not a Renaigse like the others. He bears our likeness. Please share your knowledge with us. Grant us the chance to understand.
Very well. I'll attempt to help you make sense of what you witnessed. The ritual you saw is a ceremony to summon forth the strength of our warriors. Our people have always lived in harmony with nature. Our very existence revolves around her.
No.
She talks to us and takes on many faces. What you have witnessed is just one of many. Confronting the threat that the Renoixi make up, we called them for their blessing, and they appeared to us.
Can we contact them? I mean, is communication possible?
What you witnessed was not a discussion, but if you visit a sanctuary, you may see one of the faces, and then you will be able to talk. Pass the mountains and head to the swamps. There, if you perform the ritual, you will see them come. Though what you will hear may not be to your liking.
We still haven't got to ask that wise woman about the cure yet.
What an astounding place.
My mother told me about this place. She said that the village was devoured by the houses of the Sands. How could their chief accept this?
All that's left to do is to find Father Eustanius.
Welcome to Eden, the lighthouse of faith, harmony, and civilization in these wild lands.
Thank you. Desarde, I'm the legate of the merchant congregation.
And I am Father Eustanius. Delighted. And what may I do for you?
I lust over Eustanius.
The Mother Cardinal has asked me to investigate the theft of these tablets you discovered.
That's excellent. The loss of the tablets is a catastrophe. We have to find them at all costs. If you want to learn more about these tablets, you should go ask Sister Eugenia. She supervises the theologians who discovered them, and were also guarding them. You should find her a bit further in the village, with her colleagues.
Who are the suspects of this theft?
The heretical brutes of the village of Vedlug most likely had a hand in this. They must have wanted to please the demons they worship by stealing the holy word from us.
How could they have learned of the tablet's existence?
Perhaps the demons are giving them this power. Unless one of the natives living in the village innocently mentioned them. They are so naive. Either way, I am certain that the heretics are involved in this matter.
I must leave you. Goodbye.
May the enlightened always keep you in their divine blessing.
I wondered how my people could accept the priests settling in their home like this.
It all seems a bit too convenient. If we find out some information about the history of Eden, maybe we'll change our view on things. The theft of the relic is probably not a coincidence.
Turn the fan on, hot here. Is there a stream timeout? Hour 42. Learn the story of Eden. Will educate me?
Father, I'm glad to see you, my child. What can I do for you?
Tell me about how you created this village.
We did not create it from the ground up. It was built around an existing native village. The islanders called it Vigsenegad, which translates to the village of the old sage. We saw it as a sign. The natives had probably chosen this name in memory of Saint Mateus, and everything here fit the description of Saint Lucius. The discovery of the tablets proved us right. So, we decided to rebuild our Eden here, in the spirit of peace and harmony which is described in the scriptures.
Why share this village with the natives?
To replicate and resume the work of our founder, of course. If he came here, and manage to convert the natives, then it is our duty to do the same thing. By living side by side with them, it is much easier for us to pass on our teachings.
How well do you get along with the natives who live here?
Very well, of course. Especially since those who opposed our presence left.
Left? To go where?
Oh, to other villages, I imagine. Does it even matter? Those who stayed are on the path of enlightenment. Some of their legends must have been about Saint Mateus. That helped to convince them.
And how well have neighboring villages welcomed you?
With some reluctance, to be perfectly honest. So, we sent the missionaries. There are still frequent conflicts with the village of Vedlug, a highly violent village of heretics. But the other villages, the more peaceful ones, are slowly starting to listen to the sacred.
There are no Onol Manawi and no warriors here either. Did they all leave?
Perfect harmony takes time, my child. I have no doubt that one day we will manage to convince your kind to convert. But in the meantime,
Urge
we must die. Seek for the miracle of great coexistence that this place already represents. Nobody thought we could live side by side with your people. And yet.
I must leave you. Goodbye.
May the Enlightened always keep you in their divine blessing.
I don't know where those gauntlets yet. We can.
Hello. The Mother Cardinal asked me to help you find the tablets that were stolen. Can I ask you some questions?
Of course. But hurry, I have a lot to do.
You're an NPC, you don't have anything to do.
I talked to Father Eustinius. He told me that you were supervising the theologians here.
Indeed. It is under my supervision that the research on Saint Matthias is conducted.
On whom?
Whom do you suspect of being the thief?
I'm afraid there are many suspects. These tablets are priceless relics. Some settlers may have fallen prey to the lure of profit. The heretical natives of Vedlug may have wanted to take them away from us. Or it could have been vengeance by those who had to leave the village.
Where were the tablets the night they were stolen?
We were keeping them in one of the village's shacks. We intended to bring them to San Mateus later. But first, we wanted to examine them in order to obtain as much information as possible. You can go and take a look in the shack if you want to, but I couldn't find any traces of forced entry.
I imagine someone was keeping watch over them.
Of course, we took turns guarding the shack. But some of us can't have taken the task that seriously. If I remember correctly, it was Brother Virgil who was guarding them that night.
Well, thank you for these pieces of information.
I am the one who should be thanking you. Especially if you manage to retrieve the tablets for us.
The Mother Cardinal told me that this village had been developed on the basis of Saint Lucius's writings. Are you one of the theologians who helped in its creation?
Yes. I was sent here to confirm that this place is indeed the one described in the writings. And then I stayed.
What was the reaction of the natives when you arrived here?
Most of them were not in favor of us living amongst them. They were afraid we might chase them out of their own village. And there were even more protests once we started talking about searching for traces of Saint Matthias. I suppose they thought we would destroy all of their raised stones and other places of superstition.
Were there any confrontations with the natives?
Yes. The warriors of the village attacked us. The Ordo Luminis actually had to intervene. The Inquisition managed to make them run away. The Islanders tried to attack again with the support of Vedlug, but we stood our ground. And when Lur, the chief of the village, finally accepted our presence, things calmed down.
Thank you. This information will certainly prove to be useful. Thank you. I will let you work.
We don't know everything we've eaten now, don't we?
Greetings, Desade. I am handling the investigation into the theft of the tablets. Sister Eugenia told me to talk to you.
I'm Brother Virgil. What would you like to know?
According to your colleague, you were the one in charge of guarding the tablets on the night of the theft. Is that right?
Indeed.
What can you tell me about that? Did you hear or see anything?
No, nothing in particular. The night was quiet, and then the morning after, we saw they were gone.
Someone had to enter the shack to steal the tablets. How did that happen?
I have no idea. The door was closed in the morning, and the lock was intact.
Do you suspect anyone in particular?
Not really.
What I can tell you for sure is it is not one of us.
Well, Sister Eugenia did tell me that the tablets were priceless.
Of course. But our motivation is not the lure of profit. All that matters to us is their value as proof, not the money we could make out of them.
Do you think the culprit could be a native?
Well, since none of us did it, it seems obvious. There aren't many other settlers around here, and the natives knew of the existence of these tablets before we found them. They were attached to them too, in their own way.
They are the ones who led you to them.
Well, we conducted the research, but they helped us find where they were hidden. Some inhabitants of the village are still giving us a hand with our work.
Well, thank you. I will investigate where the theft took place.
As you wish. But you won't find anything there. And why does it matter, anyway? There were witnesses to the discovery of these tablets. We have all the proof we need. And that's all that matters.
He's in on it.
What do you mean?
Now we can prove Saint Mateus lived here. Our actions on this island are justified. To keep rummaging the way Sister Eugenia does will only create more tension with the natives.
I was not expecting a theologian to say such things. Have you been in Eden for a long time?
2 months, approximately.
Love you long time.
Back then, there were still some pagan natives in the village. I joined Sister Eugenia's team with some of my colleagues, so we could give them a fresh outlook on things. We arrived straight from Teleme, hoping to study some new texts. But once we were here, I understood that my real mission was with the islanders. We must bring the light to this island.
You talked about a mission with the natives. What did you mean by that?
I may be under the command of Sister Eugenia here, but my superior is Bishop Domitius. Our mission is to banish pagan cults and convert the entire population to the light. The island belongs to Saint Mateus, and therefore to Teleme, since the God of Light offered it to our founder.
If your superior is Domitius, you are a member of the Ordo Luminis.
The hat gave it away.
Find one of its members side by side with the missionaries. We usually do not get along.
The order goes everywhere the light needs to be revealed.
You have a very unique way of seeing things. I doubt everyone accepts it. How are your relations with the natives?
When I arrived, we were still trying to obtain information from them about Saint Mateus, but they were very reluctant to give us any answers. We were also trying to educate them. Our attempts eventually made some of the inhabitants of the village react badly. Most stubborn against our teachings, the warriors and the marked. The ones the natives called the Onomenawi. They eventually left. And it has proved nothing but a blessing for us. I would like to go back to work now, if you don't mind.
Of course.
Don't let me stop you.
I will leave you to your work. Goodbye. There is only one entrance and the door shows no evidence of a break-in.
This priest, Virgil, said that the night was calm. So calm that he probably fell asleep. So, the thieves only had to take the key from him.
It's very likely that that's what happened. But someone must have informed them. It can't be a coincidence that they decided to steal it during the watch of the only neglectful guard.
You think that the one who told them is in this village?
We know that this theft could be an act of vengeance by the natives who were forced to leave here. They must still have allies in the village, family or friends. We should go talk to the chief of the natives. He will certainly know who is close to the exiles, and enough about the researchers to inform them.
Story beat.
Hello. I am Lair, the village leader. Well, I was the leader of this village.
Hello. Desarde. I am the legate of the merchant congregation.
There are Onol Manawi among the Logaid Blau. I did not know that.
Now you do.
What do you want from me?
I've heard a lot of things about this village of Eden, but I'd like to hear your version.
I'm not sure I have the answers to all of your questions, but I'll try.
Tell me about the arrival of the people of Teleme, and how you received them.
The priests were roaming around the village. They were saying that it was the place where their saint had lived. They were asking questions, talking about the Lloyd and all these things. One morning, they were building houses next to ours, and we had new neighbors.
The priests told me that they had managed to convert you. How did that happen?
As long as we refused to listen to them, they were violent, and they destroyed some of our sanctuaries. So, we let them talk. And now that they think that we love their god, they leave us alone. Some of the things they say are beautiful, and their magic is impressive. But we do not forget our spirits.
One of the theologians told me that you would help them in their research.
They wanted to find tracks of the old sage, of the one they call Saint Mateus, and they were rummaging through everything. Our Donegada did not want to tell them anything, because the old sage is sacred here. But since they violently interrogated everyone, I thought it wise to guide them to the place where the stones were.
What happened to your warriors? Why did they have to leave the village?
They did not accept the presence of the priests and their questions. They tried to retake the village. They even asked Deirdre, the chief of Bedlub, for her help. So, the priests called the Soul Lasser, the Burning Sons, and they killed many of them. Oi asked for peace, and the others left us. They wanted to join Bedlub. Perhaps they have done so.
Aren't you angry after all that happened?
No. I mourn those who died, of course, and the Vosh Direct. But this village may be our opportunity.
Your opportunity for what?
For the Renaitse to understand who we are. Not savages, nor monsters, but men. Perhaps wiser than they are.
I think I know who stole the tablets.
Really?
You do?
I believe those who were exiled from your village seek vengeance because the missionaries forced them to leave. They must have taken the tablets with the help of someone else who stayed here.
You may be right, but you may also be wrong.
Charisma.
You do well to tell me what you know. Once the priests have reached the same conclusions as I have, how do you think they will interrogate you?
You're probably right. The Inquisitors would come back, and my people would suffer. I do not want to break the peace that I did all I could to make. I think the name of the woman you are looking for is Vindwal. She helps the priests who seek the old sage.
If she's helping the priests, why would she betray them now?
Her son is one of the warriors who had to leave the village. He is filled with anger and fury. If you go talk to her, please, do not hurt her. She is but a mother who
who acted according to her son's wishes.
I have no intention of hurting her, but things may not be so simple when it comes to her son. I have to go.
Like so many others.
I knew that the story would be more complex than we'd been told.
The priests separated this village into two parts. The exiles must be broken-hearted, having left their clan behind.
Had they been wiser and accepted their new neighbors, they'd never have been forced to leave.
Either way, the resentment here is strong enough for a theft to occur.
Speaking of theft, let's do some looting. Volcanic stones? There's any other armor we can equip. Vind wall, you're my wonder wall. What do we get here? Barragus of Yorglins have built a north nest northeast of Eden. Be cautious if you follow the road to the northeast to go in the bushes. Reward will offer helps to destroy the nest. We can supply the traps. Traveler's Grave. I appeal to the better nature of travelers on the Vedabel Road. My brother decided to explore it and never returned. If anyone finds his body, please dig a grave for him so that he may rest in peace. You still have coin purse on him. I believe it is your reward. I can just take his coin purse anyway. Can't promise I'll bury him though. Strength. Guy does not use weapons. He does magic. Oh, oh, he's a magic man.
Greetings. Are you Vindwar?
Bertia Tumad. Yes, that is me. What do you want?
What can you tell me about Lair, your former leader?
He is a man of peace. Some people dislike him, not me. Everything he did to save the village. But I think the Mind Shakers made him forget what we are. Almost speaks like them now.
Mind Shakers. Give them back, bitch.
Listen, I know you helped the exiles to steal the tablets of Saint Mateus.
No, this is not true. It wasn't me.
There's no point in denying it. I know you did it for your son who had to leave the village.
If you know that, then you know that I don't have the tablets. So what do you want from me?
The only means of alleviating the situation with Teleme is to give the priests their tablets back. So, if you don't want your son to suffer their wrath, it would be best if I could retrieve them discreetly.
Bran and the rest of the exiles are hiding in the woods, beyond the stone circle. If you want to take the tablets away from them without being seen, do not take the path on the left. It is riddled with traps. And please, do not hurt my son.
I'll just break his legs as collateral.
here's the place that Vindwal indicated. The exiles must be near.
These people have been banished already. There's no need to add death to their list of punishments. Let's try not to fight them.
Don't worry. We'll be discreet.
Remember that we were told the area on the left was a trap. It would be smarter to take the other path.
What are you doing here?
I'm not here to fight you, but I must retrieve the tablets of Saint Matthias.
What? How do you know we have them? And how? Not for thee. We will not give them back. We lost our homes and families, so the priests lose their sacred stones.
Charisma to the rescue.
I know that you are seeking vengeance. But the priests will not be the only ones to suffer the consequences of your actions. Your mother helped you. And once they find out about it, she will pay the price in your place. Is that what you want?
No. She only told us which night we could come. They have no right to punish her for this.
I doubt the Ordo Luminis will care. They will need someone to take the blame, and she's the obvious choice.
Very well. Take the stones and leave. All that's left to do is to rejoin the Donea Exregal.
Back into the fold. I thought I'd have like stealth in there, I guess not. Yoink. And now, a jump cut back to the camp, I would say.
What are you doing here?
I was worried for my son. I wanted to make sure that everything was fine.
He's dead.
Don't worry, all is well. I managed to convince him to give me the tablets.
That's just joking.
Ad Loredar, I did not believe my son to be so reasonable. You are giving me hope. I will go see him and tell him to find another clan. A place to welcome him.
And
I retrieved your relics.
Thank you. Thank you immensely. Thanks to them, we will be able to continue our research on Saint Matthias.
I am curious to know who is responsible for this theft. The culprit must be brought to justice.
Who's that guy?
I don't want to point the finger at anyone. You have your relics back, and that's the only thing that matters.
Your indulgence honors you. But how can we be certain that these thieves will not strike again if they are not punished?
A good start would be to keep a better watch on the priceless treasures that you find.
Had you respected this village, you would not have to look for a culprit. You settled here without even asking those who lived here for their opinion on the matter. Instead of talking about harmony, start taking action to really make it happen.
But that is precisely what we desire more than anything. We may have been a bit clumsy in the beginning, but we'll make sure to improve things in the future. You really were a great help. I would be most grateful if you agreed to continue helping us.
I might come back at some point, but alas, I'm very busy.
Naturally. Either way, we are certainly capable of continuing our research without you.
Actually, I must go back to my world. Our next expedition must depart as soon as possible.
Your next expedition?
Our brave researchers must continue to follow the tracks of our founder on this island. In the meantime, here, take this as a token of gratitude. The help you gave us.
Thank you. I hope your expedition will be a success.
This is a chewing gum. What the hell, man? What do you give me? What did he give me? What was it? hat? Oh, neat, how wonderful. Quest items. Well, I guess that's about it for today, guys. We had great progress. We busted not one, but two plots of the Ordo Luminis. And, yeah, we talked to a tree, so it was a very exciting time. I'll thank you for watching, and I hope you're back for more later. See ya.